or natural sentence you hear. But in fact, I would say that a teacher should not say, I will complete the syllabus. Or I will cover the syllabus. Because the role of teacher is uncovering the syllabus. Don't go for covering it. Why you want to cover it? If you cover it, students will not come to know what is there in the syllabus. What teacher can do is, this is the syllabus, and what I am trying to say is, there are some elements which I came to know, which I referred, and I am giving it to you. If you find some more resources, some more extra information, get it somewhere. So that should be the attitude of teachers for present generation, and hence we are failing in that quality crisis. And overgrowing establishment. All of a sudden in 2006, a bunch of colleges came or existed in the country. Almost 50 to 60% of new colleges came, and which leads to the deterioration of quality in the country. Earlier some colleges, the old colleges are still good. They are maintaining their reputation, they are working for the benefit of student teachers, but the newly established colleges, they may be some good colleges. I'm not blaming all the colleges, but most of them are not in a good position to give the quality education. And that is the important criteria. In future at least, we should concentrate on need-based learning. If really teachers are needed more for this country, then give the permission. Otherwise, not required to give the permission. Only because of the stakeholders who are giving the funds to the NCT, who are depositing the fund to the NCT or something like that. Then mismatching the teachers is also a very important problem we have. Somewhere teachers are very sharp, students are not up to the mark. They won't leave, they won't understand what you are saying. In some cases, students are very fast, teachers are not up to the mark. So that is a mismatch. Actually, it's very difficult to understand how to resolve it. How to resolve it actually. And nowadays students are more tech savvy. If you just address them with the help of conventional classroom techniques, they won't listen. They want something like their PowerPoint presentation. They want to have some of the activities through mobiles, through computers. They want the CDs to learn. They want the websites to get the information. So this is also a problem we are having now, but that should be resolved. And the next element is poor integration of skills. If you talk about skills in the teacher education, you only concentrate on micro-teaching skills. No. That is only an aspect in the teacher education program. And we have plenty of skills. And that's where we are failing in most of the areas. We train them how to teach, but we will not train them how to handle the students. We never train the student teachers how to be a good colleague with the other colleagues. We won't train them how to behave with the elder teachers, and how to support the younger teacher. These are all the aspects we have to concentrate on. So hence, the life skills are very important for a teacher. Unless he or she have the life skills, they will not teach or they will not imbibe the skills among the students. And techno-pedagogic skills we have, techno-savvy skills, information savvy skills, emotional skills, human development skills, spiritual skills need to be integrated in teacher education. There is no need to teach separately. These are the skills which are very essential and which should be integrated in the teacher education curriculum or in activities. That's very important. And spiritual skills, what we do naturally, we teach philosophy to the students. And after teaching or after learning that subject, it's very difficult to answer what is philosophy is all about. And many times, incidents were happened actually. One man came and asked a 50-year-old man, "Who are you?" And that 50-year-old man replied, "Till today, I am not able to understand who I am. Please tell me who I am." This is philosophy. Teaching is not a philosophy. Understanding who I am, understanding other person is philosophy. Understanding or carving a way for my life is philosophy. That is to be imbibed among our student teachers. That is the need of the hour. And the next is separate modes of education. We are giving only conventional mode in teacher education now. But the old is more ahead. It is giving electronic mode of teacher education. It is giving face-to-face mode of teacher education. And it is also giving distance mode of teacher education. We find many courses around the world. They are giving different modes of teacher education. And shall I continue? Okay. And there is a little contribution to the higher education from teacher education. That's a big gap we have. We only teach, we only prepare our students, and we never think of the higher education system. We consider ourselves as the separate domain. But in fact, teacher education is a part of higher education. You take technical education, you take medical education, you take value education, integrated education, teacher education, vocational education, they are all part of higher education. So hence, we should concentrate on contributing to the higher education as well. That's a need of the hour now. And we have good old philosophies. That's again a big problem. We have developed some of the good old theories, and still we are maintaining the same theories. Still we talk about behaviorism in the classroom. It is an old theory. Talk about social constructivism now. So, lots of new theories are coming up. Hence, it is very essential to address those theories and apply them in the teaching learning process so that we can solve our own problems in the classroom. We can solve our own problems in the teaching fraternity. And identity crisis is also an important criteria. We have a crisis of identity. People will not respect you because you are a teacher educator. People will not, and you cannot, sometimes we cannot claim that also. Sometimes we feel shy to say that I am a teacher educator, because that is the case we have now. We are treating the teacher education system as a market oriented, as an industry. That we all know that. Though it is an industry, but unless we have some kind of values, some kind of ethics, you cannot claim that we are a teacher educators. Or we have a separate system of education which stands different from higher education. So which is largely poor, that has to be established in future. And lacking motivation is also lacking us, like we don't have specialized teacher education system, we don't have personalized teacher education system, holistic approach is not there in our teacher education system, and even the integrated teacher education systems are rarely found, which are missing in our system. So we have to concentrate on all those aspects so that we can say that yes, it's a very comprehensive system which can guide all forms of elements. By having all forms of elements, we can guide the student teachers for a global perspective. And the next important element is inadequate technology in future. It's a big problem again. And still teachers are very much dependent on a layman who starts the LCD. We can prepare PowerPoint presentations, that's it. If something happens in middle, we don't know what to do. Because we never tried ourselves to learn the things. Because they are the minor things, it's not a big thing. Think that we have learned so much of theories. We have so much of analytical ability. We prepare the question papers in a very difficult manner, but we don't know how to start the system. The reason why is apathy, that's all. Just we haven't concentrated on that, and if you just concentrate and spend some time on those skills, definitely you would be masters, and which is very much required for teaching learning process, which is very much required for all the activities of teacher education system. And little choice based. Choice is very less for teacher as well as student in the system now. I came to know that still CBCS has not implemented in your course. Semester system has implemented it, seems to be. But CBCS is a very good platform wherein the student teachers get opportunity to choose some of the papers, to choose some of the options they will have, and naturally we can provide the e-platforms or various forms of face-to-face, distance, electronic-based in choice-based credit system. That is a very apt one, because MHRD is also suggesting all the universities to have CBCS. The reason why is US has already implemented it, and most of the developed countries have already implemented semester system as well as CBCS. And if our certificates would be considered at global level, means each university must have CBCS and semester. That is the rationality, nothing more than that. And also, students will get some opportunities to choose some of the papers. So that's the basic thing for having CBCS and poor research scenario. We know that. Most of us are doctorates, and every teacher educator wants to be a doctor. But the rationale is why they want to conduct the research. Just for the sake of degree, that's not a research actually. And teachers may experience lots of problems in the classroom. And we say that I have 10 years of experience, and some may say that 20 years of experience. Very good, fine. What kind of problems you face in your classrooms? What kind of problems or lacunas you find in the policies, in the programs, in the activities? The same thing can be considered for PhDs. If they could have considered them, I will at least most of the problems would have been solved in India. But what we do, as rightly mentioned in the inaugural letters, just changing the sample, just changing the number of the sample will not give you a good results, will not solve our problems. And that is the difference between the research which will be conducted in the West and India. They concentrate on the real problems. And before considering the problem, they work for at least 1 or 2 years. And what we do, you can understand how our students will come. They will just come to you and approach and say that I want to do PhD. If you ask them what kind of problem you have selected, they say, you give the problem, we do. This is a natural thing you find. But in real sense, why a guy should feel a problem? Because he has already done his PhD. Unless a researcher feels it, and it should be addressed by a group of specialists, fine. A tuning can be done by a guy, but not teacher should or guide should give the research problem to students. So that attitude should change first. Taking the research problem from the guide, that attitude we should change now. Otherwise, our problems will not be solved. Nobody will come from America to solve our classroom problems, to solve our policies, to change our policies. That's not the case. So that is, poor scenario of research is very rampant in teacher education, not only in B.Ed., it's in M.Ed. also. I am a teacher of M.Ed. I have experienced this, and my students are laughing actually. How the four students are my research fellows? They are laughing. This is the same scenario you find everywhere. And illusory laboratories. When a special team comes to visit, we will see some of the laboratories in the colleges. And after their visit, you won't find any laboratories. It's very, very, some mesmerizing thing happens actually. Some jadoo will be done. Don't know actually. Before coming, no labs. When the team visits, you find some labs. Some materials will be there. They will be displayed in a very neat manner, as if first time they are displayed. And soon after the visit, they go somewhere. Some colleges will come and they take the material. So this is the scenario. How would we use all those labs? See, government can just make some policies, but implementation part is ours. Being a teacher educator, it should be our ethics that whatever we claim, we should give to the students. And we say that teachers are the nation builders. By stretching our chest, we say we are the nation builders. Are we really building our nation? And sometimes we have to ask ourselves, are we teachers? Because we are cheating. We are cheating, exactly. Are we not cheating? We are saying that we have all the facilities to come and learn the things here, but we are not giving them. We are saying that we are qualified and masters. We will teach you everything. We are not teaching them. And many teachers are there. They are only the sake of name. You find many teachers in teacher education. They say that I have 20 years of experience. They never gone to the classroom. And still they say, we are the teachers. Unless you teach in the classroom, how can it be you called as a teacher? This is ethics. This is your failure. And students, why should they follow me? Follow us? Why should they follow you? Unless you are a role model, they will not follow you. So hence, illusory laboratories we are having, and some are there actually, but they are in the bad situation. And insufficient practice teaching is also a big problem. We say that we have made our students to give 10 lessons, but in fact, 6 or 7 lessons would have been given. But we signed for the next 3 lessons. And still you believe me, in 1958, Bloom has developed a taxonomy. After 60 years also we are using the same taxonomy. Where we are? I know research has conducted in India whether that taxonomy works or not. And nobody is ready to say this is the good old fashioned, we don't want such taxonomy. We need to have some new taxonomies. Some solo taxonomy has come up now. Nobody is known for that. So depending on the old taxonomies will not work actually. And we have some good approaches like participatory approach. For participatory approach, you need not to use the Bloom's taxonomy for that. And for holistic approach, for activity-based approach, for constructivist approach, for interdisciplinary approach, these are all the different approaches we have. And the whole world is using those approaches. And still we are more relying on Bloom's taxonomy. And rare in-service and continuing teacher education. In-service training we are not at all giving. As rightly mentioned in the inaugural address, only for the sake of marks or the points, the aided school, aided college teachers or the university teachers are going for orientation or refresher courses. What about the rest of the group? Because as I told, 85% of the teacher education system lies with private. And is there any no need for those teachers' orientation or refresher? So there is a need actually, and as I told, it is very rare or insufficient. Unless we update ourselves, we cannot give the best goods to the students. And another very important thing is ICT illiteracy. We are not updating ourselves because still we think that there are some formulas of education, principles like known to unknown, simple to complex. Still we are believing that only. But a child of a 2-year-old will operate the mobile more easily and flexibly than us. Where he has learned it? Where the child has learned it? Do you still consider that easy to complex? It has learned complex things first. Not easy. So we have to think that really those principles are working today. They have to be changed. Because the learner will get the information from different sources now. Teachers are not the only sources. Students will get the resource from different sources. And hence, you cannot claim that the old principles will work out now. If you just hold a 2-year child, earlier it used to take a pen. But now, you have the pen and mobile, it will hold the mobile now. It knows. It exactly knows which is beneficial, which is attractive to it, not the pen. So maybe in future, all the teacher educators should teach with the help of either computer or mobile or laptop or any other device. We may not find any such classes in future because virtual classrooms are coming up now. Students may learn from their homes, just they will open the laptop and you can teach them with the help of video conferencing. You be there in your room only. There is no need to go to the classroom also. And they will be in their homes or somewhere. Just they open it with the help of Skype. We have a very easy software now. And they can have the video conferencing and they learn the things. So future classrooms would be very dynamic. And so that is the need actually. As I told, we should be literates in ICT. And the boom for teachers is blended of open education resources. We have plenty of free softwares which are available in the internet. If you use them, you can reach your students to a greater extent. Like for content, if you want to prepare something, if you want to teach, GeoGebra is the best software. Geometry concepts can be taught very easily. It's a very good software. If you want to create something, we have Hot Potato and CMaps. If you want to create some models, diagrams, very good thing. And for evaluation also, you can prepare your own question paper in the internet. You can post it to your students. They will write, they will answer the questions and they will reply to you or they will send it to you. You can evaluate the answers in online only. No required to come to the classrooms now, even for writing exams. And we have some of the learning management systems like Moodle and Wikispaces. You can create your own learning strategies in the internet with the help of those softwares. And you can also manage the communication platforms also with the help of Classroom 2, WebFest, and many statistical tools we have now. No need of calculators. The students are bringing calculators into the classroom means they are still in the old age era. Then, and all these things should be interwoven in the curriculum. What I mean to say is, try to have these activities with the help of softwares. Ask them to prepare a question paper, but not the hard copy, with the help of a software. By which, they will get the skill of using their software, as well as the competency of preparing question papers. So that should be the motto. And teach technology integrated teacher education, like as I told, now we are shifting from web 1 to web 2, and in future, web 2 to web 3. Web 3 technologies will be more and more into the teacher education system, and open courseware, open softwares, and e-teaching education will come into the picture now. It will definitely come. E-teacher education through electronic media, we have to train our students. Hence, smart classes are coming up. Our students know blackboard skills, but they don't know how to use the smart board. And in interviews, naturally, the teachers will be asked, do you know how to use a smart board? If they say no, no. They will lose their opportunity. So hence, and still, we don't have any communication skill based on the smart board. We are not prepared. Still we are concentrating on blackboard only. But blackboards are vanishing day by day in the classrooms. It's also very important. And e-learning and e-testing concepts are very rampant in future. And another few points like invalid recognition and accreditation. It's a big problem. It's a policy problem, as I say, because we have to accredit it to the NAC. We have to take accreditation or recognition from university, from NCT, different centers. NCT will say something different. University will have something different. And NAC is saying something different. There is no correlation or there is no coordination between the elements. So it's a big problem for teacher education centers. If only one, some similar dimensions can be prepared so that we can have good accreditation and recognition pattern in India. And public-private partnership is very lacking in India. Because there are some private sectors which can help, which can monitor, which can fund to the education institutions. Normally what we do for any kind of a program, we go and ask them the help, the monetary help, or fund collection we do, but in most of the time actually in US or in developed countries, they are the part of the institution. They always fund. They always look into the activities, the processes which carried out in the education setup. So that is required for now. And interdisciplinary and multidisciplinary concept is still lacking actually. And still your college is the best college, as I can say, because you have integrated college which should be the model for the whole world, for India. Because in RIE we have only one college in Karnataka which is giving integrated course, that is BSCED. But recently NCT has rightly pointed out and suggested that in future teacher education should be the integrated one. It should be integrated with the all degree courses, and in that relation yours is the best example, as I can say. And hopefully we can have more interdisciplinary and multidisciplinary aspects in future. And some of the aspects if you consider for ICT and e-learning, we have some explosive upcomings. We can use all those things actually. Like online and e-learning is okay. We have lesson plans. As I already mentioned actually, we have some softwares. Webcast is a best software. We can make use of that software for writing lesson plans. Where students can write something and they can post it to you. You can examine, you can review it online, and you can give feedback to them so that with the help of the softwares, we can make some corrections in lesson plans also. Because not naturally what happens, only on Saturday they come to the colleges to take the help of a guide or a teacher for lesson plan correction. But if you do it online, there is no need to come to the college also. That's how you can reduce the energy, the time, even, and whenever you get the free time, you can correct it. And discussion groups we have, like Google discussion groups we have. Google groups you can make with the help of those groups. You can help your students in disseminating the knowledge, in solving the problems, in guidance and counseling. Everything can be done with the help of those groups. And blog is the best method to give the information, to publish whatever you feel, whatever you view. So create your own blogs, which is very free. Just you can, if you have the email ID, you can get the blog very easily and give your names as a title, or if you want to give any titles, you can give it. And whatever you teach in the classroom, some glimpses you can have it, you can upload it to the blog so that students can have it after your class also. Nowadays, not required to give the notes to get the Xerox copies. Give the soft copies to them. Today they may be not getting, but tomorrow definitely they will try to learn something from the internet and they can have your information also. And website is a very good tool for teachers, because important information can be uploaded to the website, important documents can be uploaded, important intimations, information, and any important things you want to give it to the students or to the parents or to the society, you can upload the information to the website. And even the best lectures you organize in your classrooms, the videos can be uploaded to the website. So that could be the best thing for a teachers or institution. And in internet you get plenty of free books written by Bruner, written by Rousseau. Emily book is available, Bruner's book is available, and John Dewey written Education and Democracy book is available, which they are available freely. Just inform the students that to have those books, and they can explore the knowledge also. And even articles are there, reports are there, videos are there, lots of discussions. And if you are teaching psychology, you get all the videos related to the learning things. Instead of explaining all the things in the classroom, just show the video and ask them what has happened. And then you can discuss the issues in the classroom. So such important resources are available in the internet. And micro teaching skills, you can just record individual students' skills and you can upload them into the website, or you can circulate them with the help of mobile phones so that they can view again and again. They can learn, they can come to know their own mistakes and they can modify the skills. So that's what we have done actually. First time with the help of mobile phone, we tried to develop skills, teaching skills among student teachers, and we got the good results. So that can be done. And mobile phones, freesms.coms are there nowadays. No need to pay a single pipe. Or if you just log in into that website, you can send as number of as SMSs to your students, or anything. And that can be there actually. WhatsApp is there, Hype is there. Make your own groups, group of your method students, group of the whole B.Ed. class or the teacher education class, and you can circulate the information, circulate the files, circulate the PowerPoint presentations within no time. And students can access it very easily. And we have some slideshare.coms now, freeshare, slideshare.coms. And whatever PowerPoint presentations you give in the classroom, if possible, upload them to the websites so that anybody can have and access those slides. You can't believe actually, till today I have uploaded some 15 slides related to different themes. And yesterday I have seen the statistics. Till yesterday, 24,000 people have viewed my PPTs. Can you believe it? And believe me, from US, 5,000 people have viewed it. We say that US is very strong in knowledge, but they follow us. If you give rightly. The reason why I am telling is, don't restrict yourself to a single class. Because outside the class, plenty of people are there to have the knowledge. They are expecting the views of a good teachers. You may be one among them. So help others also. Okay. So classroom is not restricted to a single group of students now. The whole world is classroom. And sometimes we may also get some information from others. In that situation, I being a learner and somebody being a teacher. So it changes from situation to situation. I may be teacher in my classroom, I may be learner in the internet. And somebody wants your information, somebody is using your information, he will be the learner and you will be the teacher. So, in that perspective you have to think, and we have some e-GAN course and IGNOM. They are the good repositories. You get all the B.Ed. and M.Ed. materials free in those websites. Just download it, use it for your classroom and share with your students. Why you give the notes to them? No need to tell actually. So we have plenty of repositories now we can use, and they should also know the different websites like NCERT, NCTE, UGC, DSCRT, what they are doing, what activities they are performing, what they are releasing. So it is very essential to be known by the student teachers. And another important aspect for the next generation, I will tell you, MOOCs, Massive Open Online Courses. These courses are available freely to the teachers as well as the learners. Anybody wants to learn, anybody wants to have a certificate, yes, they can have. But they charge for certification, not for learning. That's very important. And I will give you another option also, Commonwealth of Learning. Commonwealth of Learning, it is a MOOC provider which is providing free certificate also for teacher education. Teacher education certificate course it is giving, and anybody can have it. After completion of the course, you will get the certificate also. That is the trend now. And in future, we may have MOOC programs also. So, these are all the MOOC providers. USA Coursera is a platform, edX is a platform, Udacity is a platform. They are all the MOOC giving platforms. Courses are giving by them and they are running by USA. So like that, different countries are running different MOOC programs. In India also we have some of the IITs are running some MOOC programs. Just check them and have any of the programs. And we have some tools also. As I told, for science we have different tools. For mathematics teaching, we have different tools, softwares. For logic, different softwares. For social study, English. These are all the different softwares which are available freely in the internet. And just look into the software and expose the software to the students. And we have some of the other free softwares like lecture capture. If you want to capture your own lecture, we have some softwares like OpenCast and Matterhorn. It's a software freely available. Just download it. You can capture your own lecture, record it and give it to your students. When you will be absent in the classroom, think that tomorrow you will be having class, you will be absent. Just play the video. Isn't it? So that would be the scenario for future classrooms. And online lectures you want to do from your home only. Think that tomorrow 10 to 11 you have a class, you will be there in the home. Or so because of some problem you cannot attend the class, you can teach them with the help of online lectures. Let them have a screen like this and you can teach and you can discuss also with the help of Big Blue Button, is a software, open meeting software. Just type the name of software in the Google, you will get downloaded. And video streaming, we have some softwares, and assessment also like Robo software is there. You can make your assessment, your students' assessment also. And for classroom tools, interactive whiteboard software is the best software. Wherein this is like a board wherein you can work anything. You can draw any figure, you can show the video, you can paste something, you can delete something, you can erase something. Anything can be possible by having this software, that is Open Sunkode, name of the software. If you are having laptops or systems, please download it and you can use it very easily. And for mathematics, these are all the important softwares which are available free, like the R project, Scilab, Axiom, GeoGebra, SciPy, Graph, Octave, plenty of softwares are there. The softwares will help you to teach very easily. And the ready-made content is also there. Just you have to pick what you want to give. That's a teacher training now. don't overload yourself every day. There are some softwares which will help us in disseminating the knowledge in training. So we can make use of those softwares. And another simple softwares we have, Google Forms, wherein you can create the questionnaires. Multiple choice questionnaires can be prepared very easily through online, and you can send it to all the students. They will respond it online only. Survey documents you can prepare, and the data also you can extract it to Excel also. How many male students have given yes, how many female students have given no, anything like that. And SurveyMonkey is also a very important software for preparing question papers, for preparing survey notes. And even if you are doing researchers, those softwares will help us in getting the information. Nowadays the days are gone actually to printing all the tools and giving it by hand. No, just give them with the help of email ID, that's all. And as I told, Commonwealth of Learning, you get a certificate course also. And TMOO is a resource portal where you find plenty of teacher education resources in that software. www.temoa.info. Free information, free resources are there. You can download, you can copy, you can edit, everything can be done. No plagiarism at all. They are giving it free. Okay? And some of the computer assisted assessment is possible with the help of Fortpedagos. Online assessment is possible. And even sometimes we can prepare such diagrams by adding all the words and juggling and something like that, which is Tagul software, which is there, which is available freely in the internet. Just type the words and you can prepare your own diagrams. And the reason why we are talking about ICT is India is also very keen, which means MHRD and higher education sectors are very keen to implement ICT in the schools and colleges because of these reasons. Don't think that teachers are the only ways to implement it. No, schools are well equipped now. Schools are getting computers, schools are getting internet facilities. So even 250,000 gram panchayats are now getting 100 Mbps internet facility free, and hopefully in future also all schools and colleges will be well equipped with systems as well as internet connection. So hence it is need. This is the right time to change our style, and we should prepare our student teachers for next generation. And we have some e-journals also, free available e-journals, doaj.org and sciencedirect.com. You can have free journals. And by using all those things, what we can do is, yes, earlier we used to say that work hard. Now it has changed to work smartly. Don't work hardly. It is not required, it is not need of the hour. If a work will be done within an hour, means that is more better than the work we are doing in a day. So hence it is very important to work smartly. And what we require in B.Ed. colleges or in M.Ed. centers are a teacher with blend of education principles. We should understand very well the principles of education, because those are the base for transacting. With that, we should have the educational software knowledge also. It's very essential. Unless we know both, we cannot execute our activities, our plans, our programs properly at the B.Ed. college. But what we are doing actually, we need a computer teacher who is master in certificate course, computer certificate course or MCA. We don't want such people, because it is we who have to learn the skills of computer and make our student teachers to understand the computer principles or the education principles by using computers. That's a rationality we should develop. And the role of teacher is also shifted now. How it is shifted? We have to behave like an encouraging thinker. We have to encourage the students to think in a different manner. That is the role of a teacher now. No need to give all the stuff to the students. And the information provider, just say that there are many repositories, many areas to find the information, and you go and get it. Just provide the information. Don't say everything you know and don't give every information to the students. Otherwise, they will be handicapped. That's what we are doing. Always we are saying that you read this book, you follow me. Why do you have to follow you, Manas? Because only a part of information I can know. The whole world, the whole sea is somewhere actually. So it is the role of a teacher now to provide the information and a role model. Role model means in a friendly nature. Role model means in a collaborative nature. Role model means in a cooperative manner. Please train the student teachers to behave properly with the colleagues, to understand the feeling of colleagues, to build a good rapport with the colleagues. What is happening is, it is entirely missing in the teaching fraternity. Some may be good, some may be bad, fine. But still, there should be some rapport. Because the era is collaborative era. The era is cooperative era. So hence, the role model is very important. We should behave in that way. And teacher as a facilitator, just facilitate the learning process. That's why I used to say, every student will have his or her own competencies and capabilities. Understand them properly and give the right motivation and information. That's all. They learn themselves. And teacher as a participant in the learner's efforts. Always what we do, we give the homework to them. We give the assignments to them and we won't help. And the perfect product we expect, don't do that please. When we give some work to the students, means try to be there with them. If they feel some difficulty, if they need some help, help them. That's what the role has changed now. And teacher to find his own teaching style. Don't copy other teaching styles. Because after teaching some more years, or so many years, I will have my own teaching style. But that should be on rational way. That should be on rational way. That should be cooperative way and collaborative way. So have your own unique style of teaching. You should match the student's attitude and opinions and recognize himself as a professional. This is very difficult. We talk lot about the future teachers. We never talk about ourselves. Say what you have done, how you are, and give the choice to the students to follow or not to follow. That is professionalism. And next, be sensitive to students' needs and problems. Don't be problematic to the students. That is very rampant in B.Ed. colleges. Always, I don't know what you do, you should bring. No. Tell them how to solve it. Help them how to solve it. Be sensitive. They are also human beings. They are also human beings. Isn't it? And what is the role of a teacher? Some minds have come to you to learn the things, isn't it? What you are doing, you are saying that I am serving the mankind. Which we say, no, we are all the teachers, we are serving the mankind. Fine, somebody is coming to serve the mankind. How you have to treat him? What should be your approach to handle him? Because he is coming for society, not for himself. Am I right? So that is the thing we should understand for the next generation. So please be friendly with your friends. And be a role model so that they can choose you as a role model. Students should choose it. We should not say, just follow me. No, they should decide to whom they should follow. So hence, to conclude my presentation, this is very important thing for a teacher. And Stanford Center for Innovation has rightly said that teacher should include 4 C's. Very important C's. What are those? One is concerned. Teachers should have concern towards field, concern towards profession, concern towards learners. He should be committed. He should accept the responsibilities and perform it in a very right way. Creative. Wherever he or she gets the opportunity to show something new, to do something new, do it. And competent also. We should have skills, we should have values, we should have knowledge. We should have well understanding also, so that we should be competent enough to say that we are the right teachers for this era. And hence, the educational system can be as good as its teachers. In a day, you cannot build a Rome, isn't it? In a similar way, you cannot develop a good nation by having such kind of a teachers. If every teacher is good, naturally the whole system would be better. And hence, who is a good teacher? A teacher, one who dares to teach and never cease to learn. Never say that I won't learn. You should learn. Until and unless you be in the profession, you have to learn, you have to modify yourself, you have to change yourself based on the needs and expectations of students as well as education system. If you do that, if you understand that, certainly the next generation would be the best generation. And please consider that the students which we are preparing, those student teachers will be the teachers of the next generation. Next generation. So it is a bound duty of all the teacher educators to understand the situation and plan for the next generation. Thank you very much for your patient listening, and I hope I have considered some of the elements of new dimensions of 21st century. And thank you very much for your patient listening and following in the session. Thank you.
Thank you very much, sir. Through your keynote address, you have illustrated the various areas and dimensions in the area of higher education. I would like to say that your whole keynote address is in tune with what Nelson Mandela says, that education is the most powerful weapon we can use to change the world. It is necessary to strengthen teacher education in India, you said in your keynote address, and it is the duty of teacher to uncover the syllabus. The teacher should concern that I am not a teacher, but an awakener. The role of the teacher as an awakener that you have meditated. Sir, you meditated over a scenario in the area of research in teacher education and the new areas emerging in teacher education. A very realistic picture that you have created in front of us through your presentation. And finally, you have given the right and very basic definition of teacher, in which you have said that one who dares to teach and never cease to learning, that is the teacher. I would like to further add that the value of college education is not learning many facts, but the training of the mind to think. I have quoted Albert Einstein, sir. It's not my view, but I like this. With this, we are very, very thankful for enlightening us, for, you can say, illustrating various areas so systematically. Yours was a very systematic kind of a keynote address. We are really very thankful to you. And to propose the vote of thanks, may I request Dr. Sujata Pandit ma'am.
In the first session, we all experienced a very insightful and thoughtful and eye-opener keynote address by Honorable Dr. Jagannath Lange, Head of Department, Kuvempu, Karnataka University, Karnataka. Sir, we say that it is the destiny of India is now being shaped in classroom, but how is it possible today? And sir, explain us how to prepare for 21st century. There are various challenges before teachers due to technology revolution, information explosion, changes in value pattern, and global competition. Sir, also focus on various new dimensions of education. Sir, also explain us how to strengthen teacher education and how to prepare ourselves to accept the challenges of 21st century. Sir, I am very much thankful to you on behalf of our college, and also I am very much thankful to Dr. Maimunda sir, chairperson of this session. Thank you.